We're in the middle of a battery revolution. A few years ago in 2010, the energy on a lithium-ion battery, which is the kind you get in everything from mobile phones to electric cars, cost around about $1,400 US per kilowatt hour, which is how this kind of energy is measured. In 2023, that was down to just $140 per kilowatt hour. That's incredible. In fact, it's one of the fastest cost reductions in any energy technology ever. And that's not all. Over the same period, the amount of energy that can be stored on those batteries has doubled. Now, lithium-ion batteries have been around commercially since the early 1990s, but there are increasingly exciting alternatives. The ones you can see being built behind me here are based not on lithium, or in fact on any metal, but on completely organic materials.
We need to think bigger. We need to think in raw materials which are really, really abundantly available. And then it's very consequent to do what our founder did, to look how nature solves this problem. And it's nature is really consequently using only organic materials for energy storage and energy transport. Organic material is abundantly available. There is no issues with the raw materials. And this is why we changed to organic batteries.
What the robots behind me are assembling are membranes of electrodes which are stacked together and used to convert electrical energy into chemical energy that can be stored over long periods of time. And the use of advanced robotics here at CMBlu is pretty important, because what companies like this are showing is how automation and economies of scale are driving a revolution in battery technology.
We are an R&D company, and now we need to industrialize. So, you know, through ABB, having a partner which brings that expertise in from the outside is very crucial for us, because only, you know, if we have industrialization and if we do have economy of scale, we are able to produce at costs which are then feasible to make that energy transition which we talked about earlier happen. So I do think it is one of the bigger puzzle pieces which we need to plug into the energy transition. So I do think it's a very exciting time. We're seeing that solar production becomes very, very cheap. We do see that solar combined with battery is cheaper than conventional power plants. So I do think we, you know, have everything in hand to make that energy transition a success.
And all of this matters because the linchpin of the energy transition is energy storage. Why is energy storage so crucial? Well, there's two main reasons: transport and power generation. The deployment of battery electric vehicles grew by about 40% in 2023. And as batteries get more and more powerful, that's going to mean not just electric cars, but also potentially electric trucks, electric heavy goods vehicles. But the really crucial role for battery storage isn't on the roads, it's in industry. In fact, already 90% of battery demand is coming from the energy sector. And that's because renewable energy often fluctuates by its very nature. The sun has to be shining, the wind has to be blowing for you to get any kind of power out of those resources. It's what they call in the industry intermittency. But of course, the demand for that power isn't intermittent. People want to watch TV or turn their heating or air conditioning on at any hour of the day or night. That means that to make renewable energy work, you have to have a way of storing that energy so that you can use it whenever you like. Until quite recently, that's been a challenge for the industry, but now energy storage systems like this are finally able to take up that challenge. One of the modules being built here holds 200 kilowatt hours of energy. That's something like 25,000 times the power of a mobile phone battery. But the real potential comes from stringing them together or linking them up in stacks in a way that simply isn't possible with lithium-ion batteries for safety reasons. And that could create, in effect, energy warehouses which can hold millions of watt hours of power. That's the vision here. Bringing battery electric storage systems online isn't the end of the story, of course. A lot of these systems require new solutions to old problems, like how switches and breakers work, how power is distributed locally, how the protection systems function. And technology is evolving there too to meet these new battery-based setups. Finally, it's also really important that the battery revolution is part of the circular economy that industries and communities are trying to get towards. That means that batteries have to incorporate recycled materials, and there has to be a plan to reuse the materials that are involved. ABB's electrification business, for instance, has a free take-back service on batteries, which is designed to make sure recycling rates get up to 90%. Here at CMBlu, they say that most of the parts of these modules are also recyclable. And of course, a part of that circular economy is the ethical one. Batteries depend traditionally on quite a lot of crucial raw materials, especially lithium and cobalt, which are concentrated in just a few countries. And there are concerns about the human cost of extracting those minerals. That's what makes CMBlu so exciting, because this system uses no metals and relies on materials that are organic and universally abundant. So the impact of new battery technology and ethical supply chains is going to have a big impact on so-called upstream industries like mining. But that's perhaps a subject for another video. The main point for now is that one way or another, this has to work. There is no move away from fossil fuels unless there's a way to store that intermittent energy that we get from renewable sources. The International Energy Agency have a master plan to reach net zero emissions. It's called the NZE. And in that plan, 60% of the reductions in CO2 emissions by 2030 are associated with batteries, which means these things being built by robots behind me are the key to making the energy transition work.